give you catching up with some old friends. Friday night's kicking off a three-day weekend. Last second prayer in the hometown team wins. Friends and Lowe's play it again. That's a reason to raise them up high. That's a reason to drink all night long. Keep them coming around, hold them down. Be loud every chance you can. You got a drink in your hand. That's a reason to raise. That's a reason to raise them up high. Summer nights, long seats, sold out show. New year, new me, same champagne toast. Girls gone trying to bounce back cause your heart's broke. It's time to let her go. That's a reason to raise them up high. That's a reason to drink all night long. Keep them coming around, going down. Get loud every chance you can. You got a drink in your hand. That's a reason to raise them up. When your brother gets back home from overseas, that's a reason to raise them up high. That's a reason to drink all night long. Keep them coming around, hold them down. Get loud every chance you can. You got a drink in your hand. That's a reason to raise them up high. That's a reason to drink all night long. Keep them coming around, going down. Get loud every chance you can. You got a drink in your hand. That's a reason to raise them up. That's a reason to raise them up high.
She'll see my name and pick up. to drive. The clouds up in the city, the weatherman complains. But where I come from, rain is a good thing. Rain makes corn, corn makes whiskey, whiskey makes my baby.
But baseball has marked the time. This field, this game, is a part of our past, Ray. It reminds us of all that once was good, and it could be again. Oh, people will come, Ray. People will most definitely come.
The House of Onyx has been serving their customers since 1967. They have items for guys and gals of all ages in any price range, starting as low as $20. They don't just sell gifts, they sell memories that can be handed down for generations. At the House of Onyx, you will find jewelry, minerals, fossils, as well as polished, tumbled, and even unearthed crystals. Stop by anytime, Monday through Friday from 9 to 4, no appointment needed. Let Renee and her team help you find your next gift for that special someone that will be enjoyed by generations to come. The House of Onyx, 120 North Main Street, Greenville, Kentucky, 270-338-2363. On behalf of all the hits, Star 107.3 and Mustang Sports Nation, we would like to take this time to thank Double S Farms for all they do for our county, our community, and our student athletes. Wherever a need exists, you will find Double S Farms. All right, Mustang Nation, we are about 15 minutes away from the first pitch. We are here in Florida. Beautiful, overcast days. The kind of weather I like. No humidity. We're probably upper 60s, somewhere in the low 70s. I haven't checked, but we're going to be taking on the Red Hounds of Corbin, Kentucky, a traditional baseball powerhouse. So we're going to get first pitch here in about 15 minutes. Hang with us. She swore there were no waste of time on, but she was wrong.
a scratch off tick, bought 2 12 packs and a tank of gas with it. She swore they were a waste of time, all, but she was wrong. And I was copper number 5 on the radio station, on a 4 day, 3 night beach vacation. Deep sea senorita fishing down in Panama.
Turn it up, son. All right, boy. This is her favorite song, you know that, right? So we play it good and loud. She might get up and dance again. Uh-oh, she put her beard down. Here she comes. Left, right, left. Shooting 8 ball, throwing darts at the wall, feeling damn near 10 feet tall. Here she comes, Lord help us all. OTW's girlfriend done slapped him out his chair. Poor old boy, it ain't his fault. It's so hard not to stare at that honky tonk, but don't. Keeping perfect rhythm, make you wanna swing along. Got it going on like Donkey Kong. And shut my mouth, slap your grandma. There ought to be a law. Get the sheriff on the phone. Lord have mercy, how she even get them bitches on that honky tonk, but donkey dog. Oh, son. Now, honey, you can't blame her for what her mama gave her. It ain't right to hate her for working that money. We're hanging out till 3. We'd hate to see her go, but love to watch her leave. It's on, but don't. Now keeping perfect rhythm make you wanna swing along. Got it going on like Donkey Kong. And shut my mouth, slap your grandma. There ought to be a law. Get the sheriff on the phone. Lord have mercy, how she even get them bitches on with that honky tonk, but donkey dog.
Oh, that's what I'm talking about right there. All right.
Is it sports and it's Muhlenberg County? It's here. Star.
Shut my mouth, slap your grandma.
Touchdown!
Basket. Get the sheriff on the phone. Lord have mercy, how she even get them bitches on that honky tonk, but donkey dog. That honky tonk, but donkey dog.
That's it right there, boys. That's why we do what we do.
So real quick, Mustang Nation, I'm going to go to the schedule. You guys can capture that somehow. That's going to be a schedule of the upcoming and the past games. Mustangs have won both baseball games. The girls went down in a very close contest against West Jessamine yesterday. But if you can do a screenshot of this, you'll know when I'm going live and all that good stuff. Quick look at today's lineup. Up the pitch going back. No, just kind of, yeah. All right, got my lovely assistant trying to work out the radar. We're picking up the pitch going back, not the pitch coming in. All right, so Mustangs taking on the Corbin Redhounds.
here in beautiful Fort Walton, Florida.
Mustangs are the home team. Dalton will pitch for them.
So Dalton Brigham's on the mound, and he's going to start. First pitch fouled off left side.
Cam leads it off for a foul ball.
Dalton comes set. Now the pitch up and in. That ball hit on the ground, second base. Gloves thrown across.
Out number one. Cade bats second.
All right, so Mustangs one out. I'll get you updated here. And Dalton Brigham's reeling on the mound. That one fouled back. So Dalton up early, 0-1 count, one out. And the pitch. Curveball hits right side, and Logan Thomas there for the second out. So their third spot hitter,
Walker Landrum.
Walker Landrum steps in for Corbin. Again, Corbin is the Red Hounds. Foul tip. Held on by Colton Carver. 0-1 count. Dalton Steele working ahead early. That one hit straight away center field. It's going to be deep. But Eli DeBoer will have nothing of. That ball getting over his head. Puts on his wheels. And makes the catch. Attaboy Eli. Way to get it done.
And it's Muhlenberg County. It's here. Star 107.3 loves our athletes. Home of Mustang football, touchdown, basketball, and more. We do the work so you don't have to. Star 107.3, your home for Muhlenberg County Mustangs athletics.
Hey, don't worry with it too much. That net really affects it, so. Okay. Coming to the plate, the red hot hitting Eli DeBoer. exchanges pleasantries with the catcher and the umpire. Just an absolute superb kid right here.
Helton pitching for the Redhounds.
That ball inside. Not only is a superb kid, but he is a superb five-tool ball player. So what a better combination. Eli DeBoer watches the first one stay in. Good eye on him. That one's going to go high. And I would highly recommend Corbin not walking this young man. He can hurt you with the bat, on the bases, with the glove, any way, anywhere he's put. He can bring down the storm. Fouls that one off. For the first strike. 2-1 count. Pitcher comes set. That one up. 3-1. So Eli up, looking down at it. Pitcher likes throwing from the stretch. A lot of people do. They just feel more comfortable. Oh, and he bounces that one about 7 feet. 3 inches in front of the plate. That's a calibrated eye
on the leadoff
that
ball.
I've got there. So good job, Eli DeBoer. That's okay. Thank you for trying. It's that net whenever it's not pulled tight and I can't get against it.
Carver Rice to hit.
So with a runner on first. Oop, that's the wrong thing. Carver Rice comes to the plate. Spins, thinks about a bunt. Carver, the youngster on the team, 0-1 count. The only starting sophomore right now. Extreme talent coming through the ranks here. Mustangs have future greatness and present greatness on the field. Pulls back, good one. Eli, seeing what's gonna happen, gets there and he's under it. Atta boy, Eli.
Eli DeBoer.
So way to get it done. Eli says, sacrifice or no, I got this, my man. Helping his teammate out, young Carver Rice. Looks in at the general, Coach Shelton. Gets a new call. Thinks about it. Pulls around, he is gonna bunt and lays it down perfectly.
Third baseman will field it and throw it.
And he'll throw it across, nice job. So Eli DeBoer moves up with only one out. Game changer right there, way to get it done. Carver Rice making his grandfather back in Kentucky, Mr. Jeff Kirby, very proud, as he is all the Mustang Nation. So the veteran lefty, first baseman, 19. Logan Thomas knows what to do here with the runner in scoring position. Eli with the kind of wheels again that can score many different ways here. Pass ball, wild pitch. Sacrifice, hit, or even just steal a base. He's got that kind of wheel. Jackie Robinson type speed, you'll remember. The master of stealing home plate. Eli knows the skill set that's at the box, however, in the veteran Logan Thomas. Not going to do anything crazy. Going to wait on his fellow senior. That one down, 2-1. Logan working ahead. Mr. Umpire does not like the cleanliness of the house. Sweeps it off there. Tells Logan, all right, let's get this done. Catcher bends, Logan steps, and we are ready. That one low, 3-1. What an eye here. Doesn't get any easier, as you can see on deck in this view. The very talented Talon Cartwright, looming in the background. 3-1 count, one out. Logan goes after that one, likes it. That'll drive the count full, 3-2. Logan comes set, ready, goes after it, hits it a ton, right field. And the right fielder able to run it down, but that will score the run. Way to get it done, Mr. Logan Thomas. Here you're going to see the low five, Eli to Logan, saying thank you for getting me in, my man. Logan says easy peasy. So sorry, the second Talon out. Cartwright. Hadn't had my outs up. Now, with two outs, Talon Cartwright steps in the box with two outs. So Mustang's on the board early. I'll get that score up there here in just a minute. And Talon watches the first one go past. One ball, no strikes. That one low, 2-0. On deck, the big guy, Deacon Addis. That one low, 3-0. I swear, from last year to this year, Talon seems like he's grown at least 6 inches. He is a tall one. That one out's going to walk him. And a runner back on first for your Mustangs.
Talon,
good work there, Talon.
First on the wall.
And that will bring Deacon Alice, senior number 32.
Add us to the plate.
In the box. The pitch. Call the strike, inner portion. Corbin stays up. 1-1 count. So today I do plan on swinging to the softball game as quick as I can. They will start at 1 o'clock. I'm obviously going to be late because this game started at 12. So we'll get there as quick as I can. You'll be able to tune into that one. One ball, two strikes, and two outs. What's up, G? How are you? Miss Linda Mallory, one of my favorite people in the world.
How are you?
Stops
doing?
By. I'm doing very good. Very good. Glad to see you. I don't get to see her very much, just in Florida. So a 2-2 count. And two outs, Deacon trying to get the work done. That one in, swings him back. He's going to drive it full. 3-2. And Deacon awaits the pitch. That one up and out, going to walk him. And the Mustangs putting together quite a thread here, even with two outs, runners now first and second. And the pitcher of record, Mr. Dalton Briggins, comes to the plate. So Corbin, coach, wants to get together with his team, talk it over. Mustangs putting together a good thread here. Dug out quite jovial, as you can imagine. Mustangs up 1-0. And we are in a fantastic spot.
Dalton Briggins up to hit.
So Dalton Briggins with the ability to help himself here. Runners first and second, Deacon on first, Talon on second. The pitch, Dalton goes after it. Dalton the pitch, that one low, 1-1 count. Cortland Holmes on deck, ready to back up his pitcher, if given the chance. Even count, 1-1. And a strike called, now 1-2.
Go, four.
So Dalton ready to protect here. The pitch. Foul tips it. Catcher hangs on.
Helton gets out of the inning. Mustangs score the first run. 1-0.
And the Mustangs on the board. Quickly and firstly, if you will, 1-0.
The House of Onyx has been serving their customers since 1967. They have items for guys and gals of all ages in any price range, starting as low as $20. They don't just sell gifts, they sell memories that can be handed down for generations. At the House of Onyx, you will find jewelry, minerals, fossils, as well as polished, tumbled, and even unearthed crystals. Stop by anytime, Monday through Friday from 9 to 4, no appointment needed. Let Renee and her team help you find your next gift for that special someone that will be enjoyed by generations to come. The House of Onyx, 120 North Main Street, Greenville, Kentucky, 270-338-2363. So we're going to the top of the second inning. Dalton Briggins. Ready to bring it on the mound. First pitch low. One ball, no strikes. Sun popped out there for just a minute. Now it's decided to hide again. I'm all right with that. That one, a little up and out, 2-0 count. I was remembering this particular field last year. I knew it because you seen the, on that view right there, you can see the playground over the left field fence in the background. And my man Caden Ray hit an absolute bomb over to that playground. I was worried to death, first of all. I was celebrating. Jumped up, yanked my mic off, kept talking, didn't realize it. Macy was here with me, had to say, Dad, you lost your mic. But I was like, man, I hope he didn't kill a kid trying to play over there in the playground. He absolutely hit a scud missile out of here. So memories from last year. And I think it's 3-1 count. It is. Nice one. Outer portion. And actually 3-2. That was a full count. Good work, Mr. Dalton Briggins. So the first out made.
Helton to hit.
Mustangs up. Still 1-0. Helton. Number 9. Stands in. Left-handed hitter. Makes me think of Todd Helton. Many years ago, great first baseman for the Colorado Rockies. He hit left-handed. Played baseball at Tennessee. I think he was maybe also a quarterback there for a little while. And the pitch. Oh, that one gets a piece of him.
Helton takes it.
Doesn't feel very good, I can tell. These
Noah has one down, the man at first base.
These young men sure are tough. They're not going to show it if they do hurt. That guy just spun around, walked right on down to first base. If a ball hit me in such a manner, I'd be living out the rest of my days in an iron lung. That's how bad I would hurt. I know I've said before, you know the thing that bothers me about the iron lung is who scratches your nose? I mean, you can't get your hands out of that little cylinder if your nose itches. I got the kind of friends that would come over with a feather. Trust me, just to torture me. When they did visit, it would be all about the torture, not the friendship. That ball laid down a good bunt. Dalton, there, gloves across. Logan there to receive, and the out made, but the runner does advance. Two outs made, runner on second.
Clay Botner up.
So with two outs, the field general, Logan Carver, or Colton Carver, sorry, Logan Carver. I'm crisscrossing names here. Colton Carver walks out, talks to his pitcher, steps back. He towers over the poor umpire. Does Colton. I mean, the poor umpire back there is not. That ball hit. Shortstop! Wow! Carver Rice, what a play! Man, way to get it done. Carver Rice, attaboy.
Nothing.
On a diving play, look like Ozzie Smith. On behalf of all the hits, Star 107.3, and Mustang Sports Nation, we would like to take this time to thank Double S Farms for all they do for our county, our community, and our student athletes. Wherever a need exists, you will find Double S Farms. I would like to take this time to thank some entities that make this possible. You guys are able to watch this great live Mustang action. Due to all the hits, Star 107.3, and of course, our sponsors, the House of Onyx and Double S Farms. Thank both of those entities for everything they do and making it possible for you to see and get to watch your Mustangs back and home. I was going to say before, Colton Carver towers over the poor umpire. He is not really blessed with a verticalism as it is. So in order to peek right over both of these catchers' heads, the poor guy doesn't have to squat down too terribly much. And I think it's going to be an appeal to first and a call strike on Cortland Holmes, the senior. So 0-2, Cortland. Going to have to white knuckle down and protect. Cuts through that one with a strikeout. Good one to cut at. And the aforementioned big guy, Colton Carver here, the lefty catcher. A rare combination because
Colton Carver,
99.99 catchers have come through, have always been right-handed. So to get one that's a left-handed is quite a blessing. At any level, Colton has more benefit than just being a lefty. He is an extremely good athlete. Has a cannon for an arm. Calls pitches well, blocks the plate, and can hit a ton. That one a call strike. A one ball, one strike. So with one out, Mustangs up 1-0. That one a call strike. Colton looks at the umpire and says, hey, I believe it was low. And it's 1-2 on the count. That one stays up 2-2. Good eye here, Colton.
And a man. Two down.
Umpire is grasping here. Good one for Colton to lay off of. Umpire did not see it that way.
Luke Harden up.
What the umpire doesn't know is there's a grandmother named Miss Sheila back in Kentucky that would give him what for if she could. That's a cutter. Stays inside. Luke Harden. And a call strike. I believe it's even now. 1-1. Or 0-2. 1-1 or 0-2. A little bit delayed on the scoreboard. That one a call strike. Now 1-2. Luke awaits the pitch, goes after it, and a strikeout.
Got him swinging strike three.
Good pitcher here for Corbin.
In the inning for Helton. We head to the top of the third, 1-0 Mustangs.
Sports and it's Muhlenberg County. It's here. Star 107.3 loves our athletes. Home of Mustang football,
touchdown!
Basketball, and more. We do the work so you don't have to. Star 107.3, your home for Muhlenberg County Mustangs athletics.
It's just that simple as I-N-B-L-E, simple as can be. It's just that simple as I-N-B-L-E, simple as can be. We used to live on Instagram, worried about who all gives a damn, about where we've been and where we ended up. Then I met you and you met me, and all the rest is history. And epiphany that all we need is us. It's like 1, 2, 3, just as easy as can be. Just the way you look at me, you make me smile. Ain't no need to complicated, we both know that's overrated. We've been there, it's insane, it ain't our style. We're just simple like a six.
Well, I tell you what, I don't give a lot of compliments when it comes to music, but these guys back here, back behind me playing the music, has
Red
got a great selection.
Lucas Tarvin will lead it off for him.
And a lot of Muhlenberg's own Kelsey Hart playing. So the pitch, Dalton Briggins starts him off up and outside, 0-1 count. Or 1-0 count, sorry, got him backwards there. It's a nice one. Evens it up. Hope Dalton gets some of the pitch calls. That's a pitcher for Corbin has been getting. Umpire fairly consistent so far. We'll see, that one popped.
Tarvin to shallow right center.
Second base, it's going to be down.
And it'll drop in for a base hit.
And the runner makes it. Cortland on his horse trying to get there. Ball just out of his reach. So
lead
runner reaches.
For Lucas Tarvin will bring up Cooper McCauley.
And McCauley works his way in the box. Dalton Briggins looks at first, now goes, lays down a good bunt. Perfect one, Talon Cart right there. Picks it, throws. And a good job here on the bunt and on the play by the Mustangs. So both guys doing what they had to do. Colton. Or Carver Rice sprinting from second to back up and cover third. Should that base runner now on second try to work his way to third. Carver Rice, great athlete, very smart baseball player. I even heard he could divide by zero. That's how smart that young man is. Not everybody can do that. Carver Rice can. That pitch up, one ball, no strikes, one out. Dalton set, throwing from the stretch, looks back. And pitches. Nice one. That ball's going to be hit hard left side and foul. So the even count, 1-1 and one out. Dalton trying to hold that runner, get this out, push it to two, and hold Corbin from scoring. Curveball, great block there by the catcher. So Colton Carver, I'll tell you, constantly giving up his body to stop the ball for the benefit of his fellow teammates, this time being Dalton Briggins. But you know, when that ball's coming, your mind tells you this is fixing to hurt. What are you going to do? You going to take the pain or let the ball go past you? Colton repeatedly just takes the pain for the love of teammates. Great thing to have back there stopping this ball, and that one is a strike, 3-1. So that's what makes good teams great. When you sacrifice for one another, you are your brother's keeper, so to speak. Colton Carver definitely fits the bill. Dalton Briggins feels extremely comfortable, as do all the pitching staff, to throw to this young man. That one up, he's going to walk him. Not the worst thing that could happen. So runners now first and second. That will give us a force at third. Mustangs up 1-0.
Kay had a chance to break through for the runouts.
All right, Dalton set, still pitching from the stretch here. Top of the third inning, that pitch hit straightaway center field. There will be a play possibly at the plate. Good job, Eli, getting it in quickly. And the bases will be juiced. So with one out, Mustangs in a little bit of a pickle. Walker Landrum up. Lefty number three for Corbin. Colton directing his infield, letting them know what we're going to do in any given situation. So Dalton now pitches. Oh, nice stop there by Colton. Bumps into the batter. Batter steps out. Batter's always allowed the batter's box. Usually more pertinent whenever there is a play being made on third and a batter is in the right-hand batter's box. So batter, if you step out, you are now in the field of play. You can be called with interference, but as long as you hold tight in the box, you're one thing, you're making the catcher work around you, so you're making it a little bit harder on him, and you're not going to be called for interference. So Coach Brody wants to go out. Talk it over, high fives, low fives, all around. And Colton will find his rightful spot back at the house. One ball, no strikes. Dalton comes set, throws that one, a hit, a BB up the middle. That may be two. Eli throws it in, two runners score. And they will take a 2-1 lead on a great hit back up the middle. So runners now, first and second, nobody on third. And the Red Hounds find their way through as number four.
Mikey Neal has first and second, one down.
Mikey Neal, by name. Steps in, runner on first, runner on second. Dalton stares back. Carver Rice goes back to short, trying to hold him as close as possible.
Come on, we need two outs right here. Let's go.
So no balls and a strike with that foul ball. Dalton now working ahead. Runner takes off, and that ball's hit the third. Go to second base. Look at her, a double play, way to get out of it, Mustangs. Beautiful play. There we go, all right. Couldn't have worked out better. It was obviously a hit and run. First base and second base runners took off. Easton Mefford out there to make the play. Caught the ball on the line, knew exactly what he was doing, went back to second base, and got the Mustangs out of it. Attaboy, Easton Mefford. Dalton Briggins there, gives him five, says thank you, my man. So Corbin, however, does take the lead, and we'll be going to the bottom of the third. So Mustangs coming out here, bottom of the third. If we had to pick one place to start, this is exactly where we would want to start. The leadoff man himself, Mr. Eli DeBoer. He'll stand in and try to right the ship here for the Mustangs. That one.
Eli leads it off with the foul.
Almost ends my life. Thank you, inventor of the net. That thing would have literally hit me right between the eyes. That's why I went silent there for a minute. So 0-1 count. Eli fouls another one off, 0-2. So Eli. Ready to do the work here, down 0-2. That one stays up, he leaves it up. One ball, two strikes. Eli awaits the pitch. Cutter, man, he's got a good cut ball. I don't know if it's a slider or a curve. We'll call it a slide piece, but the first out, a very rare circumstance by a strikeout by Mr. Eli DeBoer. Eli shakes his head, okay, takes note of it. I will be looking forward to seeing him step back in. So Carver Rice, the two spot hitter, having working his way up, worked his way up in the lineup, shortstop glove, throws across
for out number two
and gets the second out. So two outs here quickly. Mustangs down 2-1. And the wily veteran, Logan Thomas. We'll step in. Go a long way with two outs. We just keep handing the bat back. That one's going to be a called strike. A one count, Logan leaves that one out, evens it up, 1-1. So again, just a reminder, softball plays starting at 1 o'clock. I'm obviously gonna be here doing this one. As soon as this one ends, I will race to the field. The good thing about it, today is the day that the softball and baseball teams probably play as close as any other day. So I think it'll be maybe a 10-minute drive over there, so I'll get there as quick as I can. So if you're tuning in expecting to be softball, you're gonna have to hold tight. I will get there. One ball, two strikes on Logan, two outs. And the pitch, that one curveball down, even count, 2-2. Good eye here by Logan. The pitch, Logan goes after it. Pitcher
swinging strike three.
Pitching extremely well.
Take the lead in the top of the third.
So the Mustangs will go silent here in the bottom of the third.
Turn it up, son. All right, boy. This is her favorite song. You know that, right? So we play it good and loud. She might get up and dance again.
The House of Onyx has been serving their customers since 1967. They have items for guys and gals of all ages in any price range, starting as low as $20. They don't just sell gifts, they sell memories that can be handed down for generations. At the House of Onyx, you will find jewelry, minerals, fossils, as well as polished, tumbled, and even unearthed crystals. Stop by anytime, Monday through Friday from 9 to 4, no appointment needed. Let Renee and her team help you find your next gift for that special someone that will be enjoyed by generations to come. The House of Onyx, 120 North Main Street, Greenville, Kentucky, 270-338-2363.
All right, Mustangs down 2-1. And number 9 for the Red Hounds will be stepping in. Dalton Briggins relying on his exceptional defense behind him.
Oh,
umpire started to rock, looked to his right like he was going to throw the punch, but didn't call it. One ball, no strikes. Spins, pulls back, thinks about a bunt. 2-0 count is the result. Dalton with the pitch, that one fouled back. Two-one. Dalton still down, looking up at it, trying to fight his way back even if he can. Oh, that one inside spins him around. And go up 3-1. Keeping him honest, says Dalton. So we're top of the fourth inning. And the pitch. Stays up. He's going
to
walk
to lead it off.
So runner on one, Helton. We'll reach first base for Corbin. Look at the height difference between
Noah up.
Colton and the umpire. Colton's like, hurry, I haven't been down, son. I can't see over you. The pitch. Oh, curveball stays up. Good one to start him on. One ball, no strikes.
Line into left field.
Line to left field. One hops the fence. Runner coming around. Easton gets it in quickly.
Second base. A stand-up double for Noah.
So runners will be on third and second. No outs here for the Mustangs. So you can see two good teams going at it here.
Two runners in scoring position.
Mustangs going to have to be very diligent. Already down 2-1. No outs here. Runners in scoring position, second and third. Dalton Briggins trying to grip that ball just a little bit tighter. Outer portion. Didn't get the call there. Being squeezed a little bit. 1-0 count. There it is. Same location, granted it was a different pitch. That one was a cutter of some type, took a little bit off. First one was a fastball. As a result, 1-1 count by way of the call. Second one, same spot, maybe a little further out. I'll give it that, 2-1 is the count. So Dalton. Nice pitch, that ball hit! Oh! Infield in, Carver Rice gets past him, runner coming home. And Talon will cut it off. Two more runs score, 4-1. Now is the score. Corbin taking a 3-run lead. So Corbin scores two in the third, two in the fourth.
Lucas Tarvin will hit next.
4-1. Runners now on first, not second and third. Still no outs. Another tough call. Close, but didn't get it. So one ball, no strikes. That one a strike, 1-1 count. One ball, one strike, the pitch, outer portion. Colton goes down, tries to pick him off on first, on the back pick. Number 12 in there for Corbin. Two balls and one strike. Umpire turns around very aggressively, corrects the scorekeeper. And Dalton comes set, throws that one low. Colton Carver does what Colton Carver does. Man, stops that ball. There'll be a bruise showing somewhere tomorrow. He doesn't care. Catchers take a constant beating, just part of the position. The pitch, that one hit.
That one's lined into right center field.
Right center field, it'll get down.
Another base hit.
Picked off by Eli, he's gonna go to second, and runners will be on the corner.
A single for Tarvin. Runners on the corners, no outs.
Colton calls a timeout, wants to go out and talk to Dalton. Like I say, catching, one of the tougher spots on the field. After every game, all catchers usually feel like they've done a 100-yard dash in a 90-yard gym. Always beat up and sore. So with runners on the corner, the field general, catcher, Colton goes out, infield pulls in. They're going to talk it over. No coaches involved here. Coach is going to let these guys work their way out of it. I know you got a lot of experience. A lot of knowledge out there on the bump. Colton wants to get his team together, figure out what we're going to do here should the runner take off. Are we going to back pick on third? Are we going to throw down? What's the plan? The light blue hats all know. We'll know here in just a minute. So 4-1 Corbin up right now. Dalton comes set to pitch. Batter looks like a possible bunt. If not, he did a good fake job there. 1-0 count. Dalton spins, looks at first. Now comes set. The pitch, that one down. He's gonna race home. Gets past Colton. Hard one to block. He tried. And the runner also advances. So 5-1. Is the current score. Runner on second. Runner cleared from third as he scored. And still no outs. Set, throws, bunt laid down. Talling on a glove, throw across, and it's out of the reach of Logan Thomas.
Coming home to score.
Another run scores for Corbin. That ball thrown.
Into second, McCauley. And with no outs, it's 6-1 Red Hounds.
And corralled by Carver Rice. So Corbin now up 6-1.
Back to the top of the lineup for Cam.
And the runner still remains on second. So the Mustangs having met up with the Buzzsaw today in the Bloodhounds, or the Redhounds, Bloodhounds. They're feeling like Bloodhounds right now, but they are the Corbin Redhounds. That pitch a call strike. Batter tried to spin out of the way and sell it being closer inside than it actually was. 0-1 count. Dalton set, looks back. Runner holds, now he pitches. That one popped up, left side.
Left field.
Easton Mefford there to make the catch. So the first out, much anticipated, finally made. By way of Easton Mefford out in left field.
Kate up next for the Red Hounds.
So runner still holds on second. Dalton throws a nice curveball. Broke center of the plate. Toward the outer portion, 0-1 count and one out. We are top of the fourth inning. Corbin having scored four runs already, still just one out. Dalton trying to put an end to it. Another
popped into center.
All speed, curveball type pitch.
Back.
Eli DeBoer goes
catch.
Down, makes the catch.
Holding at second base,
holds
McCauley.
The runner right
two
where
outs.
He's at for the second out. Nice job by the senior leader out there, center field, Eli DeBoer.
Walker Landrum steps
so
up.
Walker Landrum, big guy, number three. Lefty. Ooh, that one up and in. Steps him back. 1-0 count. Here we go. Dalton set, stares back. Colton working to push the runner back. That ball popped
Landrum
up.
Pops it up third left side.
And the ball
gets
up in the wind. Once it's blowing over top that very tall dugout you see there, kind of blows back. Talon tried to work his way back toward the foul line, just out of his reach. So as is, a long strike, 1-1 count and two outs. Stays up, Colton. Oh, that ball skips past. Runner's going to round. Eli DeBoer tries to make a play at it.
McCauley comes home to score.
And the fifth run of the inning, seventh run of the game, will find his way across. So base is empty now. Mustang's going to reset. Moms all over the left side of the field, trying to call their team down. Umpire speaking very aggressively to the scorekeeper yet again. Two balls and a strike.
That one's
going to be hit a ton. And it's off the wall.
Landrum into second base. Wall ball double with two down.
So PA guy does a good job. I didn't have to call that. You heard him, a wall ball. Hit the fence in the air, and he'll pull up with a double.
Mikey Neal up.
So the general gonna hold time, come out of the dugout. Excuse me. And I believe he's gonna have a pitching change. This will give me a time to take a quick break.
That'll be the day for Dalton. Now Austin Rowe will come in to pitch for the Mustangs.
Truck. Gonna open up the doors and turn it up. Gonna stomp my boots in the Georgia mud. Gonna watch you make me fall in love. Get up on the hood of my daddy's tractor. Up on the toolbox, it don't matter. Down on the tailgate, girl, I can't wait to watch you do your thing. Shake it for the young bucks sitting in the honky tonks. For the rednecks rocking till the break of dawn. The DJ spinning that country song. Come on, come on, come on. Shake it for the birds, shake it for the bees. Shake it for the catfish swimming down deep in the creek. And the critters in this world, shake it to the moon, shake it for me, girl. Oh, country girl, shake it for me, girl. Shake it for me, girl. Shake it for me. Country girl, shake it for me, girl. Shake it for me, girl. Shake it for me. Something about a sweet little farmer child. The cattle in her blood to get a little wild. Ponytail and a pretty smile.
All right, so the big guy, Austin Rowe, will take over on the bump. Austin, also a senior, number 12.
Austin Rowe on the mound now for the Mustangs, and he'll face Mikey Neal, runner at second with two down.
Cheeseburger and a Coke. So Austin, runner on second. 0-0 count. Fresh batter, fresh pitcher, Austin. Gets the strike call. 0-1 count. Redhound 7, Mustangs 1. That one hit hard on the ground. That a boy, Coach Carver Rice. Nice work there by the sophomore. And the Mustangs got a lot of work to do.
They lead 7-1.
On behalf of all the hits, Star 107.3, and Mustang Sports Nation, we would like to take this time to thank Double S Farms for all they do for our county, our community, and our student athletes. Wherever a need exists, you will find Double S Farms.
Baseball has marked the time. This field, this game, is a part of our past, Ray. It reminds us of all that once was good, and it could be again. Oh, people will come, Ray. People will most definitely come.
So that last little ad you saw there is kind of an appreciation ad for the concession stands at any Muhlenberg County baseball game. I'll tell you what, Scott Slinker and his crew just goes above and beyond when it comes to making food for the home games. They are exceptional. Talon Cartwright will be charged with trying to right the ship here. Mustangs down 7-1. Bottom of the fourth inning. Cuts through the first one.
Talon Cartwright leading off for the Mustangs against Helton.
Pitch, Talon goes after it, hits it a ton. Come on, ball. Off the fence. Talon working his way around. I thought that thing was gone, but an absolute scud missile by the third baseman, Talon Cartwright. He said, okay, you're going to give me the chance to right the ship. I will start it. Now we just need to pass it on back here, Deacon Addis. We'll gladly do so if given the opportunity. So runner on second, that boy, I thought that thing was gone. An absolute rope. Straight away center field. That one up and out, 2-0. Call the strike, 2-1. Deacon still up, looking down at it. I'm enjoying a nice cheeseburger. Deacon goes after that one.
Deacon, here we go. You gotta protect.
I would rate it a D minus. compared to something. Of course, and again, our measure is Scott Slinker back at home, so anything's going to be of less quality compared to his stuff. That one stays outside. Deacon with a full count. That one almost gets him inside. He's going to work his way on down to first. So Mustangs putting it together here.
Deacon Addis down to first base. Austin Rowe in to hit.
Easton Mefford will come in as a pinch runner. Austin Rowe. Will come in. Also in place of Dalton Briggins. So runners on second and third. Cuts through that one. A good fastball to go at. Finally finished the cheeseburger, so you should get to enjoy my non-slurping commentary now. It wasn't as good as the breakfast we had this morning. I had a traditional, my traditional favorite, the old sausage, egg, and cheese biscuit. Shelby had this thing called a sneeze bowl. Is that right? I'm close. Acai'd, an acai'd. Those sounds like sneeze to me. Whatever you call it. It had fruit in it and all kind of delicious stuff. She really enjoyed it. So two balls and a strike. Austin Rowe. No outs, runners first and second. And that one a call strike. 2-2 now.
All right, here we go. Come on. Head on it. Let's go.
Even count the pitch. Austin goes after it.
Got
up and out.
For strike three.
Got him on the strikeout. So that'll bring the senior Cortland Holmes to the plate. First out made here, bottom of the fourth inning. One of the moms wanted to absolutely make sure Talon found his way back to second base. Talon's never done this before, so luckily, mom's here to instruct him. One ball, no strike. That one popped up.
Was that you?
One ball, one strike. And one out. Cortland in a good spot here. Needs something productive. And he spins, pulls back, calls strike. One, two, the count. Cortland ready, curveball, call, strike on a beautiful pitch. It was a thing of beauty.
Hey, your pitch is six.
Colton Carver looks to score the leadoff double.
So the catcher, Colton, with two outs, two runners on. Looking to get something done. Watches the first one. Off speed. Four strike one. Holds back on that one as it floats outside. 1-1.
Six.
That one paints the black, if anything, on the outer portion. One ball, two strikes, Colton. At the ready, curveball stays up. Umpire thinks about it, decides better. Pitcher looks at his dugout for some help. He thinks it was a strike. I disagree, as does Colton. 2-2 count. That one low, that's full count. Runner's gonna advance. He's gonna throw down to third, and he's there. Talon Cartwright finds his way over. Oh, so runner second, or first and third. Pitch. Colton goes after it, fouls it off right side, way to hang. Back to first. I love it. I tell you, I am right in the middle of a bunch of boy moms. It's something out of my comfort zone. Typically I'm around girl moms having two daughters, but there's a lot of aggressive stuff here.
Ball four, bases loaded with two down now for the Mustangs.
So Colton Carver watches the ball and he's going to load them up. Quite honestly, I'm a little afraid if I say the wrong thing, they may turn on me. So Maddox Jernigan, the senior, is going to come in as a pinch runner for the catcher, Colton Carver. At the plate now,
Luke Hart.
Luke, an OG tough guy. That one a call, strike 0-2. Gonna have to white knuckle and protect. The pitch goes after it and gets him on the strikeout.
Out number three, Hilton gets out of the bases loaded jam. We head to the fifth inning. Red Hounds lead at 7-1.
So the Mustangs, with a lot of work to do, trying to regather themselves.
Blame it all on my roots. I showed up in boots and ruined your black tie affair. Last one to know, the last one to show, I was the last one you thought you'd see there. And I saw the surprise and the fear in his eyes when I took his glass of champagne. And I toasted you, said, honey, we may be through, but you'll never hear me complain. 'Cause I got friends in low places where the whiskey drowns and the beer chases my blues away. And I'll be okay. Yeah, I'm not big on social graces. Think I'll slip on down to the oasis. So I got friends in low places. Thank you.
All right, the Mustangs back to work here in the field. Austin Rowe
will lead it off in the top
on
of
the mound, and Helton for Corbin. We'll do the work. Gets a call, a strike. Again, if you're tuning in, expecting to see a softball game, I've got to finish this one up. Then I will head over there as quick as I can. Mustangs, softball, in the lead right now, 4-1. Bottom of the first inning against Franklin County. So a good story over there. We are in the top of the fifth here. And the Mustang boys are down 7-1 presently. So two balls and a strike. Catcher Colton having a little problem with his equipment there. Hands it off to Coach Brody. Back at this one, 2-1 count. Hard shot,
deep
that thing
right field,
is
you can
hit
put it
a ton. And it's gone for sure. He does a real good job.
Suburbs for Brager Kelton.
Yeah, that thing was hit into a neighborhood. I think it hit a family dog over there. That thing was hit a ton. And Corbin comes out to celebrate, rightfully so. So that'll be 8-1. So new count, 0-0, new batter, 8-1 Corbin, and a pitch. Outer portion.
No, it hit now.
Outside, 0-2 count. And he gets him. Attaboy Austin Rowe.
Out number one.
Taking matters into his own hands, getting the out.
Clay Botner next up.
So with one out, Austin Deal stays high. One ball, no strikes. Austin comes set, throws, that one fouled off. There you see the guys watching very intently. Austin Rowe, good frame there by the catcher, Colton, trying to help his pitcher out. His pitcher out, umpire did not bite. Two balls and a strike. Goes after it. Man, he's bringing the juice. 2-2 count. And that one low. That'll drive the count full, 3-2. With one out, top of the fifth inning. Oh, another one right back my direction. Still a full count.
Bonner
hit
short,
on the ground to short.
Ground.
Carver Rice there to glove.
Down the first base line. He'll reach.
And it gets through. I'd already looked to first before I seen what happened there. Gets past the youngster Carver Rice.
Lucas Tarvin. will step up to the plate.
So Mustang's down 8-1, and as much as we all hate it, I'm sure the coaches would back me up on this. These type games are necessary if you plan on going deep into the tournament to kind of see what our guys are made of here. They're very intently over there watching, seeing who's still fighting, who's willing to do whatever it takes to try to get back into this thing. Runner on first. That pitch up, Austin with a 1-1 count. Wheels deals a pitch. That
Harmon
one popped
up. Right side.
Right side.
Foul ground. Collision. Oh. And the catch is
Logan
made.
Thomas, and I don't have a. So Colton Carver and Logan Thomas both ran into each other. Colton a little sore. He'll be coming back into view here in just a minute. He's okay. Coach wants to come out and talk to him. And I'll tell you what, you know what kind of ball players these two that just collided here are. And what I prefaced it with a while ago was coaches wanting to see what these guys are made of. Down 8-1. And you know what? Both of those young men just proved something right there. They were willing to do whatever it took to get the out. Ran into each other. Colton hit the ground. Logan made the catch. Two outs. So no quit in either one of these two young fellas.
Two down. McCauley steps to the plate.
Proven fact. When God made Colton Carver and Logan Thomas, there was no quit whatsoever put in either one of them. You can see right there, they was not backing off. Going to make sure that out was made. It was. And Austin Rowe trying to send the hitter down. Up on him now, 0-2. Runner on. Ball up. Colton springs out from his squat position, much like a kangaroo, even after taking that hit. Still with it. 1-2. The count. That one's there. Nice ring up. And the strikeout made. Mustangs.
Redhounds put up another home run.
Ready to come in and get something started here.
We head to the bottom of the fifth.
Gals of all ages in any price range, starting as low as $20. They don't just sell gifts, they sell memories that can be handed down for generations. At the House of Onyx, you will find jewelry, minerals, fossils, as well as polished, tumbled, and even unearthed crystals. Stop by anytime, Monday through Friday from 9 to 4, no appointment needed. Let Renee and her team help you find your next gift for that special someone that will be enjoyed by generations to come. The House of Onyx, 120 North Main Street, Greenville, Kentucky, 270-338-2363. To be found.
So Mustangs softball's in the bottom of the second inning, still 4-1. Mustangs on front. Again, if you're tuning in expecting to see Mustangs softball, I will get over that. Over there should be like a 10-minute drive. It'll take me probably 10 minutes to get taken down here, set up over there. So it'll be a bit, but luckily the two parks that both of these teams play today is fairly close. So I'll get there when I can, but again, if you're tuning in expecting to see Mustang softball, it will start at the conclusion of this game. They've actually started, but the live stream will start. Mustangs up, softball world, 4-1 currently here. We're down 8-1. Eli DeBoer, the senior, steps in. Hard shot, that's gonna be a gap shot. He will run for a ways. That's gonna make its way onto the fence. How far will he go? He's gonna hustle his way on around to third. There will be a play, but he's there. Leadoff triple by the senior leader, Eli DeBoer, number 99. And again, seeing what these guys are made of, absolutely no quit in number 99 either.
Carver Rice to bat next.
So a leadoff triple, nice play there. Eli DeBoer. Hello, how are you? Had a little one come up. Interesting in what I'm doing here. That one on the ground to third. And it's bobbled. Eli's going to get there. And a nice pick on first to get Carver Rice. But Carver Rice, very consistent in making sure he scores the run. So he does there. And that's going to put it on Logan Thomas here with one out. So Logan Thomas comes to the plate. Watches the first one go past. One ball, no strikes. Hi. 8-2 the score. 1-0 count, Logan. That one stays low, gets a piece of the catcher, bounces backwards. Talon Cartwright, the on-deck hitter, will retrieve the ball. So we are bottom of the fifth inning. Called a strike. May have been too far out, I don't know. Umpire had a better view of it than I did. 2-1 count, Logan. Sees that one stay down. Good eye here, knowing we need base runners to get back in this thing. 3-1 count. Logan, a team player. Called a strike. Full up now, full house on Logan Thomas, and that one stays high. So he earns a walk, does Logan Thomas.
So it's one down, runner on first.
Talon Cartwright
will hit next.
Talon already have roped one straightaway center field on an absolute scud missile. Would love to do it again. Holds up on that one, a call strike. Hello. No balls and a strike. Talon leaves that one high. That'll even it up 1-1 with one out. 8-2 the score. Logan Thomas, the veteran first baseman on first as a base runner now. Curveball. Ooh, beautiful pitch. 1-2. Pitcher's got some slop in him, no doubt about it. He can bend it. That one stays high. Tried to come back with the same pitch. And that will even the count. 2-2. That one inside. Full count now. And the pitch fouls it off catcher.
Strike three.
Held on
for out number two.
For the second out. So that's one of those plays from a catching standpoint that you can't even practice. It's one of those by happenstance type things. I'm sorry, I got Logan on second. He's on first. And Easton Mefford with two outs, runner on first. Stands in, pitcher. Tries Logan. Logan goes back in ahead first. Make sure that mom's going to have to clean that uniform. And the pitch for Easton. Easton cuts through. No balls and a strike.
Easton hitting for the Mustangs.
Looks like the softball game has went 6-1. Now up by five. That was a curveball dropped in there. 0-2 count. And the pitch. Easton cuts through on a check swing.
Three, tag applied. Out of the fifth inning, Mustangs score one more. 8-2, we head to the sixth.
So again, giving props where props are due. Man, the music selection here is phenomenal. This is one of my absolute favorite guys, Darius Rucker. I prefer the Hootie and the Blowfish Darius Rucker, but I don't mind the country star Darius Rucker. Guys, I want to remind you all, something we're very proud of is the our voice or our Mustang knowledge, if you will. Mr. Mark Bowers does a show back at the station, back at home, every morning. If you can't catch it, at 8 o'clock there is always a upload on the Facebook page, All the Hits 107.3. So all you got to do is any time of day, if you can't catch it at 8 o'clock, Michael and Casey Davis will upload it, and you can hear all of the important information from Michael Davis and Mr. Mustang himself, Mark Bowers. They will give you the updates not only on Mustang sports, but on all the sport happenings of current events. So now they're talking a lot, obviously, about the NCAA tournaments. And pretty much anything Kentucky basketball. That pitch up and in. So make sure you tune in. Again, I'm usually working at that hour. I don't have a chance to tune in, but whenever I get a break or something, I will hit the download to make sure I stay caught up on what Mr. Mark Bowers has to say. So 1-1 count here. And the pitch. Did not announce him, but in the pitch is Jace Mefford, the sophomore for the Mustangs. Doing a fine job. And what a pitch, Jace Mefford. Way to start it off with a strikeout. So first out made by way of strikeout, Jace Mefford comes in.
Cade bats second.
Puts a quick halt on this powerful Corbin offense. That's through. does the batter on an 0-1 count. Another pitch, another one, man, having problems catching up with him. Not only that, his hat is having a problem staying on his head. He whips it so hard, that hat's even belling out on the pitch for Mr. Jace Mefford. 0-2. Another one, hat hits the dirt. Jace, nice head of hair. Every time you can see whenever his hat comes off, I'm sitting here thinking if he had my problem, he wouldn't have a problem with his hat coming off. That ball hit right side. And Luke Harden has to jump and makes a wonderful catch for the second out. So you see the heart that these guys are still playing with. Even down 8-2, but I have to shave my head. If I ever have problems with the toboggan or hat staying on, I just let it grow out a little bit and it kind of takes over like Velcro. Just kind of sticks to it. Jace loses his hat again. Maybe I should recommend to Jace Mefford to shave his head for that reason. He probably won't listen to him. I don't blame him. If I could grow hair like that, I wouldn't shave mine either. One ball, no strikes, two outs. Jace Mefford with the pitch. Oh, gets a piece of Colton on the foul. I'm telling you, catchers take a beating. Colton Carver is tough as Tarzan's feet. I'm telling you, he's still back there. Not feeling a thing right now. That ball hit right between first and second, and he will reach. So runner on first.
Mikey Neal steps to the plate.
Colton spins out, thinks about going down, does not. Colton gonna throw it down, a nice shot.
Sliding under the tag is Landrum.
Landrum quick gets in there, moves up from first to second. Colton put a good shot on him, just wasn't there in time. Hello? But he's still throwing it well, even after the hits he's taken today. Tough young man. I'm telling you, if you ever come around a corner and see Colton Carver cornered up by a bear, help the bear. Colton's got it, I promise you that. That one's a strike, Jace Mefford. With a second strike, 1-2 count with two out. Colton Carver hunts bears with a switch, I was told. I can believe it.
Runner ball goes pop, again, this time
center field between center and right. Center. Eli DeBoer gives it everything he's got.
Now Neal
and a run will score just out of the reach base of Eli DeBoer in a dead sprint. He got past his glove here by a couple of inches. I did not see the dance on second by the Corbin player. My wife would like to point out. So 9-2 now the score. Oh, put it on the wrong side. I'm just so used to giving Mustangs runs. That's where my natural intuition went. Give it to the Mustangs, but it's actually a Corbin run. 9-2. The score. This is Helton that hit a ball into a neighborhood, knocked a young child off their big wheel. Child's okay. Don't get worried. He's all right. 1-1 count. Two outs. Pitch out. Jace loses his hat again. Two balls and a strike with two outs. That ball Richard hit Kelton, hard.
Deep into left center field.
Left center
back
field.
Back towards the wall. One hops off
and
the warning track.
One hops the Held fence. The I didn't see double. It. Player between me and there. 10-2. But a run scores again for Corbin. So 10-2 the score. Two runs having scored here in the top of the sixth.
Hell up to hit for the Red Hounds.
Hilton, quite a player. I do believe he is a pitcher also. That ball hit right field.
Towards the right center
Luke
gap.
Harden makes
the
put. So the
two
Mustangs.
For the Red Hounds. Man to the bottom of the sixth.
Obviously
two,
has some work to do.
Score.
Mustang softball now up 7-1.
Come on, guys. Let's do it. Let's rally.
I found myself in this making mistakes.
So guys, this week I also plan on doing senior interviews. You guys may remember last year we had three softball seniors and one baseball senior, so I just did them together. This year it's nine baseball seniors and three softball seniors, so I'm going to do them separately, and I plan on trying to do that Thursday if at all possible. I won't go live. I will record it, and as soon as I get done with both, I will do an upload. So plan on doing senior interviews. Be on the lookout for that. Always good stuff to hear from our seniors playing their last year of their chosen sport. Inside 1-0 on the lefty here, Mr. Jace Meffer. Curveball breaks off. 1-1 count. The pitch. That one goes after it. Pitcher. Bobbles, gets away from him.
Second
oh,
base run.
Jace.
Will
reach first. So, fine play there by the second baseman. I realized the only way he was even going to remotely be able to have a chance was to try to scoop it after it tipped
Will
away
Freeman,
from the pitcher.
With his freshly tied shoes, is now pitching for the Red Hounds.
Pinch runner coming in. It'll be Peyton Carey.
Maddox Brannon hits next.
As the pinch runner, Maddox Brannon. The master closer, if you will. Coming to the plate. Pitch, all speed, up. One ball, no strike. On deck, the man beast himself, Colton Carver. Ball low, good block by the catcher. Peyton Carey retreats back to first. Pitch, another one low. Peyton takes off, and he's under. Good job. Heads up play by Peyton Carey. Knew it was going to be a little tougher to throw on a ball down in the dirt. As it was, that was the saving grace as Peyton Carey finds his way into second. So Maddox Brannon with a chance to score him here as Peyton is in scoring position. Now the pitch. The pitch. Outer portion and low. Nice job by Maddox Brannon. So runners applying a little bit of a threat. Runners first and second. Maddox Brannon on first. Peyton Carey on second. And the man beast, Colton Carver, steps in from the left side. Thinks about a bunt, pulls back. One ball, no strike. A slight drizzle now starting to fall. If we were in Kentucky, we would be worried, but this happens all the time here in Florida. That one outer portion called a strike. 1-1 count. 8-1 Mustangs now taking the lead from a softball standpoint. Ahead 8-1 against Franklin County. Will be there after this game. Peyton Carey hung up, ball bobbled, and he's going to wake his way on down to third base. Attaboy Peyton.
Carey gracefully slides to third base.
Wondering. All right. Troy over here watching intently his son dive head first. Look like a scorpion going into third base. And Colton Carver back out of here with a chance to score him. No outs, 2-1 count. And the pitch. Colton hits it hard between first and second. Colton Carver, very consistent way to get it done. And coming to the plate, one of my favorites, Slayton Teague. I knew Slayton Teague before I knew any of the rest of these young baseball players. Slayton Teague, having agreed to make the ultimate sacrifice, he is joining the armed forces version or some type of forces version of the Navy. So he will be joining the forces after graduation. So I tell him constantly how much I appreciate him. If you run into him, if you've got his number, send him a text, tell him how much you appreciate him, because the sacrifice that he's willing to make is what allows us to be able to come down to Florida, have fun, and live in freedom because of people like young Slayton Teague. So with runners on first and second, Slayton
still no outs and runners at first and second now for Slayton Teague.
Slayton awaits a pitch, curveball, breaks it off, 0-1 count. Slayton here awaits, now the pitch, another curveball stays up, that'll even it, 1-1. Pitch. Slayton goes after it. Picks a good one. One ball, two strikes. That pitch low. Great eye. 2-2. Slayton, a senior, wears number 35. Two balls, two strikes. Looking at him. No outs. Runners first and second. The pitch goes after.
Got him swinging, strike three. Will Freeman's
low
one first
in the
out
dirt, and that'll be the first out of the game, six of the inning. And back to the leadoff here, Eli DeBoer. Eli with the kind of power that could put three runs on the board if he finds the right pitch. That one low and inside.
Eli DeBoer up to hit for the Mustangs.
Liked it. Oh, straight to third base, and just some bad luck there. A fine play by the third baseman. He caught an absolute rope, threw back to second base.
We have six outs to go.
Behind Maddox Brannon for the out. So we'll be going to the top of the seventh inning.
Reminds us of all that once was good and it could be again. Oh, people will come, Ray. People will most definitely come.
So the top of the seventh inning.
7-8-9 due up for the Red Hounds in the top of the seventh inning.
10-3, Corbin on top.
Led off by Clay
presently.
Botner.
And Clay Botner will come to the plate. And the pitch. Called strike. Jace Mefford bringing the heat. 1-1 count. Inner portion skips away from Colton. That one fouled back. I about roll out of my seat. Shelby doesn't even flinch. Two balls, two strikes. Jace brings it. A nice curveball. Wow. The young man has got a ball that can cut. So the first out here, top of the seventh.
Lucas Tarvin next up.
And the pitch. Nice one. Jace picks his head up again. That one inside. 0-2. Jace's hat falls off again. Jace. Nice and clean, but his hat, poor hat, looks like it's been run over by a bulldozer in a hog pen. 0-2 count. That one hit on the ground to third.
Slow roller.
Talon there, gloves, throws, and a nice one, Talon Cartwright. As consistent as it comes. Over in that third base position. Talon, a junior, wears number 14. And two outs made. Nicely.
Cooper McCauley up.
The Mustang softball score still 8-1. Mustangs leading. Here we're down 10-3. Chase Mefford steps off the mound, wants to regroup. The pitch. Oh, he hits him.
Gets him on the backside and he'll take first.
We'll reach first on the hit by pitch.
Cam's got a man at first and two down.
Behind you, behind you. He's holding, he's holding.
McCauley to second.
One ball, no strikes, two outs. Runner advances to second on the low pitch. Outer portion, two balls, no strikes. Pitch low. Colton covers it up. 3-0. So he walks up here, runners first and second. Number 14 for Corbin. He'll make his way to the box. So runners first and second, top of the seventh inning. 10-3, Corbin on top. And a Mustang softball goes ahead 10-1. Hopefully that game will still be in action by the time I get over there. Oh, maybe, maybe not, because I think one more run and they could possibly run rule. The pitch, low. So with two outs, one ball, no strikes, runner first and second. Jace Mefford on the pitch. That one down. Runners advancing. Colton hits the ground. I told you it was drizzling. The backstop getting a little slick back there. Out, he's going to walk. That will load it up.
Base is loaded. Two down.
So number Walker three, Landrum. Walker Landrum Let's coming to the plate for Corbin. Infield, veteran Logan Thomas coming to the mound. Give his young pitcher some words of advice. Jace Mefford with the pitch. I had my radar on that one. That was a screamer. pitch. That one's a strike. One ball, one strike, two outs. That one fouled off left side, so Jace now working ahead. One ball, two strikes. Pitch, tried to curve one in on him. Colton hustles out to get it. Jace picks his hat up. Colton Carver still working extremely hard. Bases loaded, two outs, down 10-3. And he is still getting it, giving it every single thing he's got. Back behind, there it is! Jace Mefford on the strikeout with the bases loaded. A beautiful pitching exhibition there to end that threat by the young Jace Mefford, the sophomore, getting it done.
Folks, we hope you're enjoying your spring break so far in Northwest Florida in at Andy Smith Baseball Complex at Shawnee High School. My name's Brady Burns, or Tanner. I've been the man on the microphone for you today. If you'd like to find my social media, you can find my Facebook at my name, Brady Burns. You can find my Instagram, Tater underscore Brooks, T-A-T-E-R underscore B-R-O-O-K-S. Thank you.
Coming to the plate here, Will bottom Freeman of the seventh inning.
Into shutter nine for the Red House.
The pride of Jackie and Jeff Kirby. Mr. Carver Rice, sophomore, shortstop. Trying to add a few on here. Watches the first curve go in for a strike, 0-1 count. Another one. Carver jumps on. It's going to be short in front of the shortstop. He tries to outrun it, and he's safe as the ball gets away from the first baseman. That's what hustle will do for you. Nice work there, Mr. Carver Rice. So giving the Mustangs something to hope for here. Runner on first. Logan Thomas will step in on the left side. Senior trying to push the sophomore along. Call strike outer portion. Stays up, 1-1 count. Hit softly on the ground, and it's going to be trouble, and it works. Luck be a Mustang right now. Logan Thomas hit the ball perfectly. Couldn't have done it better if he tried to bunt, but between second, first, and the pitcher, out of all of the reach and the hard hitting, great third base plan. Junior Talon Cartwright steps in the box. Two on, a chance to get something done here. That one skips away, bold. Runners will advance. Catcher has to run it down. So runners for the Mustang now, second and third. Hope being applied here. Two runs on Talon Cartwright. still intent to hit a Scud missile somewhere, somehow. Already having hit one earlier today. I think it made it over the center fielder's head, probably one hop the fence. That one gets a piece right on the ankle. He's going to shake it off. I would require probably a hurricane for several years after a foul ball like that, but he shakes his foot, steps back in the box. A hurricane. All right. Talon Cartwright. Much as that one stay up here. 2-1. I know. Something's wrong. Curveball in. 3-1. So a ball away from loading the bases here. And on deck is Easton Leffert. Liked it, goes after it. And that'll drive the count full here, 3-2. Oh, that one broke off severely. So good job here, good eye by Talon Cartwright.
Still no outs.
And Easton Mefford deprived of Miss Linda Mallory, the lady that was over to talk to me earlier.
Easton Mefford
steps in the box. So bases loaded, no outs. Easton Mefford steps in from the left side, facing a left-hander. Her ball stays up. Ball still up 10-1. I hope they don't end it before I can get over there. Playing very well today. Easton Mefford goes after that one. That'll even the count 1-1. That one a call strike, 1-2. Ready for the pitch. That one breaks down, skips away. Runner's gonna come, and attaboy. Arbor Rice there scores the run. Runners will advance.
Arbor Rice scores, 10-4.
So 10-4, Mustangs putting a little bit of a nick back into it. Nick is smaller than a dent, but one run will take regardless. Count. Runner second and third, bottom of seven. That one stays up and out. Full count. He works it full. So the count is a full house. Runner second and third, bottom of seven. Pitch. Easton goes after it.
Got him swinging. Strike three. Will Freeman.
In the first out.
Strikes him out for out number one.
Will be made. Coming to the plate is another lefty. Jace Mefford, number 21. Holds up.
Jace Mefford hit him.
The one count. After that one, fouls it back. We'll be back around the football field. It was after that one, maybe a little trouble left fielder. coming in and makes the catch. Runners hold. Chase Mefford put a little bit of a charge into it. Left fielder caught it on the fly, and Mustangs down to their last out. As Maddox Brannan will find his way to the box.
Up to it.
So softball now leading 11-1. A one count. Maddox goes after that one, hits it a ton. Left fielder standing still. And that will end the game. So Mustang Nation, we are going to try to make it over to the softball game before they end it here. So it's over. So they ended the game before I could even get over there. Well, good for the Lady Mustangs. So if you're tuning in, I would like to say, hey, great job by the Lady Mustangs. The boys go down here by a score of 10-4. Hard fought contest. And so that means no more games today. But tomorrow, what time do we play tomorrow? The girls do play first. And let me look at my schedule here just so I know. So tomorrow it will be 5 o'clock and 7 o'clock. Girls start at 5 o'clock p.m. Boys will play at 7. So another little bit of an overlap between those two games, depending on how fast I can get there. It will be depending how fast I can go live on the boys game. Should be able to pick up all of the softball game tomorrow. Hopefully they do what they did today and end it early. That would give me plenty of time to get over here and watch the boys. So a hard-fought contest against a really good team. The Mustangs go down by a score of 10-4 in Mustang Nation. This game was brought to you by All the Hit Star 107.3. We hope that you enjoyed this live stream. And if you did, the best way to show it is to hit that like, follow, or subscribe button. On behalf of Casey and Michael Davis and myself, we would like to thank you for supporting all Mustang students. As I sign off, I'd like to remind you that the only thing fair on this side of heaven is a ball hit between first and third. May God bless you wherever you are, and stay safe. I know there's some bad weather coming through back home, so stay safe out there, Mustang Nation. May God bless you wherever you are.
Out.